Gracious Lord, on this morning of resurrection, we gather to worship and glorify your holy name. Send now your Spirit among us, Lord, that our eyes would be open to see the beauty of this story, that our hearts would be enlightened to make this story our own. In Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen. I love the gospel writer Mark. Mark writes like no other gospel writer. Usually Mark gets right to the point and says what's on his mind. And in Mark's account of the resurrection, we have a very different account than the other gospel recollections. Mark begins by specifically naming the three women who come to the grave to anoint Jesus' body. And on their way to the tomb, they start thinking to themselves, how are we going to roll that big stone away? And as they get closer, they notice that the stone is rolled away. And I don't know if you noticed this, but nowhere in the gospel does it say the women were amazed that the stone was rolled away. They never said, thanks be to God, the stone is rolled away. No, they were confused. And they walked up to the tomb. And they walked into an empty tomb expecting to find a dead body. And instead, they see a young man dressed in white, dazzling white linen clothes. And this person in there says, you are looking for Jesus of Nazareth. He is no longer here. He has risen. Go, tell everyone that Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee. And you and I, in the year of our Lord 2018, would expect that the women would say, Christ is risen.
He has risen indeed.
Thank you. That's a little. You're like the women.
Right?
They said nothing to anyone. You're like, look at that. The women were amazed, right? And actually, the Greek words that are used to describe what you have as terror and amazement, are you ready for this? Trauma and ecstasy. In that moment, these women were so perplexed because they went there expecting to find a dead body and instead found an empty tomb. And instead of grieving and mourning, they didn't know what had hit them. They didn't understand what was happening. And so this young man dressed in white linen wrappings, he tells them to go and tell everyone that Jesus is going ahead of you. Instead, these women leave in fear because they didn't know what to do with the information they had. And this is exactly where Mark's original gospel ends, in silence. I want you to think about how powerful that is. The gospel of Jesus Christ ending in silence. Didn't take long because we humans aren't comfortable with silence. We're not necessarily comfortable with not knowing the rest of the story. Within 10 years, someone unknown to the world writes the story of Jesus' resurrection and pastes it into the end of Mark's gospel. Biblical scholars for 2,000 years have wondered, why did that happen? Why did Mark end his gospel on this note of terror and amazement, saying nothing to anyone? And so all these hypotheses have been written. And all these preachers have thought about why Mark would end his gospel this way. He must have been wrong. But I wonder, what if Mark was onto something? What if Mark really had a brilliant and dazzling idea? What if Mark wanted those three women to finish the story on their own? What if Mark decided that each one of those women had a story to tell the world, and that now that Jesus was raised from the dead, Jesus would walk with them out into the world to tell and share their story? And even greater still, what if Mark wanted you and I to create the ending of our own story? To see how we view and see the power of God's love. and play it out in our very life so that the world itself might know of the great love God has for us. In this gospel that you and I have today, we are empowered by our Lord Jesus Christ, who promises to walk with us out into the world to help us complete our own resurrection story. You can decide what happens in your own life in order to fulfill the great love and mercy and divine forgiveness that God offers through the death and resurrection of our Lord. Each one of us gets to complete and finish our own gospel narrative to tell the world how it is we see the power of God working in our lives. The only question that I have is, what will our lives say? Will our lives say that the world should be filled with divisions, that we should have all these priorities before God in our lives, that we aren't really called to love one another, that we can obey the commandments as we desire, that we can do the things that we always desire to do? Or can we take the very core and essence of what Mark is trying to share with you and I? That God loved this world so much, that God loved each one of us so much, that God willingly went to that cross to die and be raised to new life so that our stories could be complete. May our lives always reflect this one simple proclamation: Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
Amen.